What's up, y'all? It's Demogenite. It's time for another one. So, some High Republic news, you know, because they're high. Why not? And before we get into this, big shouts to Clownfish TV because they brought this to my attention. Because really, I really am not interested in this thing. But when I see something that kind of needs to be addressed, that's what my job is. We've discussed this. So, let's talk about it real quick. So this is right here from the official StarWars.com. So this is the test of courage, right? And I'm pretty sure people heard about the Justina Ireland thing. We're not talking about that. Not caring about that either. We're talking about is this young Jedi Knight right here. Because it starts off right here. Venestra Rohl, a new Jedi Knight at the age of 16. So we're going to stop right there. She's becoming the youngest Jedi Knight in the Order at that time at 16. So, yeah. Her first real assignment feels like an awful lot of babysitting. Of course, that sounds like how you would make this thing with a 16-year-old Jedi Knight. But I noticed something. Between Venestra and... what's her name? Where's she at, right? Oh, here she is right here. And what's her name? Because I don't know these people. Oh, Keeve Trennis. Because in her book, she gets knighted. She becomes a Jedi Knight. So you notice a pattern there? You notice that pattern? Now, of course, Venestra is being touted as the youngest, which is crazy because Anakin didn't get knighted until he was 19. Now, granted, Anakin was a bit of a handful. He was a little, I guess the word would be rambunctious, a little crazy sometimes, which kind of probably put a damper on him. But remember, and I'm going to go by my timeline, which is the original George Lucas one. If we look at the Samurai Jack version of the Clone Wars, he gets knighted in the middle of the Clone Wars because he essentially went through all his trials within the Clone Wars. So he went through actual, like, hard body trials and then was like, okay, we get knighted. So really, I'm not reading this book. We know this is not going to happen. It's not happening. It's not. And I know you might be like, well, you can't make an honest opinion. Yeah, I can. I can tell you looking at this, just looking at this cover and just how the author was a little sideways. It's no reason for me to buy this because, again, this is a cheap imitation of what we had before. And just to paraphrase one of the comments I saw, they said Disney essentially bought something that was fine the way it was just to change it. And change it in a bad way, too. That's the problem. And you know what? Again, this would be almost more tolerable if you did this. If you said, okay, we're scrapping everything from the EU, Georgia stuff and all that. And then you start right after the Rise of Palpatine. If you would have did that, I would have had more respect for you. Because then you would have said, listen, I'm putting my chips in the butt. See, because you went for the Old Republic, you still have that anchor, which is Yoda. Remember, that's an anchor right there. And, of course, you're going right into the original trilogy. So that's also an anchor that you are surrounding yourself around, right? And they're doing, as far as like I said before, if you look at this here also on StarWars.com, these are all the books. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the 7 books for this year. And again, like I said before, it's information dump. Because when you had the EU, like I said before, you had 30 plus years to build off of this. So you can add a character here, build off it, add a character there, build off it, add a character there, build off it. And essentially, you still had that, the original trilogy and actually the Phantom Menace at that point, a lot of it, you had the Phantom Menace, where you had to still keep everything based, you know, keeping it in line with that. But you, other than that, you could still kind of go for what you like, but you did bits and pieces and made sure, you know, there was a little line, a little thread that went to your six movies, right? So all you need to do is have a little line, a little thread to go there. This right here is the whole thing is focused on the fact that it has to go right to the original trilogy, because at least with some of the books you were getting with the EU, you would get something that was moving forward. And then you can still it went backwards. You know what I'm saying? When I say forward or backwards, I mean you would get something like Exile, right? In the Fate of the Jedi series. And then you would get maybe a Lost Tribe of the Sith. Or you'll get a movie tie-in book. Something like that. And it wasn't like they were dumping all these books all over. So you got seven books coming out. Seven books essentially at one time. Again, information dump. And the only reason I know the certain people you're talking about, because, you know, they're their standouts. You know, and I remind you. So we had three standouts so far: Avar, Venestra, and Keeve. Wonder what their common denominator is. But anyway, just to give you an idea of how well this is working, if you go to the Venestra Rogue High Republic short, yeah, that's about almost it's almost about a you know, 50-50 on it. Well, I mean, you got 1,000 more likes, but that's still pretty bad when you look at something like, I don't know, Star Wars Theory talking about Luke. You got a million, almost 2 million views, 99,000 upvotes, and then, you know, 1,200 downvotes. But it's, you know, one thing too, I will say, and a lot of people have been talking about this, you know, I guess schism in the Lucasfilm era. I mean, well, Disney Lucasfilm era, I should say. But you know what I find funny? On the same Star Wars YouTube channel, I mean, there you got all Lucasfilm Games, you got Moff Gideon talking there. I'm confused. Where's your highlight for Luke? Where's your highlight for Luke? You got a highlight for Venestra. Where's your highlight for Luke? Now, granted, I know Luke stands on his own. You don't need a highlight, but you just had The Mandalorian Season 2 about a month ago now. And basically, the internet lost their mind, right? It was awesome. In a good way, they lost their mind. And you got no highlight of Luke? Nothing? No highlight of Luke here? That's kind of strange to me. I mean, that's just me. Just, you know, making an observation. But real quick, before we get out of here, just let's take a quick look at the Test of Courage, which is Venestra Rose's book here. Look at some of the comments we have here. Where are we at? So we got one star. One star, one star. Okay, we got a five star there. Two stars, five stars, four, five. See all reviews. What we got here? See, I ain't gonna be here all day, but it to me, it's got a bit of a ratio, but you still got. I mean, you're always gonna have this. I always see this here when you go on Amazon, this high five star, but you know 11% on the one. Obviously, I think you can be your when you do like these kind of charts. Really, your main thing is really probably going to be your midway is where you're going to get your most truthful talk telling. You're going to have either your complete shills or your complete dumpster fires on here, right? So, but I just thought it was funny. It had a lot of one stars there, and I'm not going to go through the whole thing. We're not going to be here all day doing that. But anyway. Venestra Rogue, the greatest unchosen one ever, beat out Anakin by 3 years, right? Awesome sauce. I'm not excited about it. I guess you can tell, right? I guess you can tell. But anyway, how do you feel about Venestra over there? You think she's gonna be awesome? Well, matter of fact, she's gonna be awesome. But I'm trying to figure out Because if they're, if they, I mean, this is what, 200 years, 200, 300 years? So I'm assuming a lot of them is probably gonna, go to, join the force through natural causes. But how well are the Jedi? And with them putting all these youngsters as your Jedi Knights, how will they hold up against somebody like, I don't know, the Sith? Because I want some Sith in there. We can't have this whole plant eating. I keep bringing this up, but you cannot have this whole plant bounty hunter pirate thing going on against the Jedi. Need some Sith. I need to see some falling. That's all I need to see. Because if you're going to tell me they were this awesome in a mere 300 years in the past, they really let it go to the crapper that bad? Well, then again, in real world, things go pretty bad in about 300 years too. But whatever. I digress. Let's get out of here. Let me know how you feel about this. Like, share, and subscribe. But of course, hit that notification bell so you get my visit and drop them. Remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace. Better off believe the president, my empire. We seek peace and justice, efficient level. My planet is spotless on top of the game. I'm done, Phil.